bring your probatorians back here, continuing that warm-up sequence. Again, we want to get those hips activated, and this time we're going to get them
activated without impact in relation to how our posture should kind of align or preemptively be set up for movement. So I'm going to get into what we call a side profile in this particular position. You don't mind moving a little bit closer here, apprentice. Awesome. Okay. I want to have my shoulder blade back. I want to have my pelvis into a good position where I'm not overreacting in any type of way from this particular position. If you want to take a step back, we're going to lift our leg up, rotate the foot to the outside, rotate the foot to the inside, and touch down that inside profile. This again is loading those smaller muscle groups that are responsible for transitions for keeping stability as I'm grabbing depth in exercises such as squats, deadlifts, and especially start adding resistance. So I can do 3 to 5 reps into this particular position. Next drill I can get into, quite a few steps here. This time I'm gonna keep my feet or my knees together. I'm gonna start with quite a few steps. So going through 1 step. People have always done this before, but we're gonna keep adding more. Here, now what we're gonna do is try to squeeze the two knees together, really inducing some reaction through your internal systems there. This is a huge one. What we're gonna do now is work on internal rotation of the hip joint, help activate the obliques, okay, and also give some stability. From here, I'm gonna kick back diagonally. When I'm kicking back, it's important that I'm not losing that organization or that stability component that I got, and I'm gonna drive back in the same profile. So I would get 3 to 5 reps of these again. From here, here, breathing through, great. Rotating through, earning that posture, earning that position without changing, and I'm kicking back. Wonders for loading up the core and the hip attachments for when you start actually adding resistance.